It's been amazing. It's been a lot of fun. I hope I coach more like him in my career because he's special. He has no ceiling. I mean, he just, you tell him to work power moves, he perfects them. You tell him to work finesse moves, he perfects them. He's violent in the run game. He's playing with great effort. He has great leadership. I mean, what can you complain about other than you don't have two or three of them?
Well, Teron just gave me a great example, and I just wanted to do nothing more than carry the torch when he left. He's been a great motivator for me and just somebody that I could always call on. And, you know, he showed me the way, and I'm just trying to pass the torch on to the next generation. And also, I really just want to take care of my mother, buy her house and everything. And I know I need to step my game up to another level if I want to do that. It's a dream come true. My freshman year, we went 3-9. Lost 8 games in a row. And it was hard. It was tough, but everybody stuck through it. And, you know, it's a complete 180 to see us from 3-9 to where we are now. And I'm just thankful to be a part of it. And I'm happy they allowed me to come back.
Largely, BYU people have kind of portrayed you as maybe of a dirty player or whatever kind of player you might want to call it. So, are you comfortable with that portrayal? Do you think it's a bit misunderstood, or are you okay with it?
I mean, I'm not going to lie. At first, it kind of hurt my feelings. I'm really a nice guy. Like, everybody around here knows me. I love to smile. I love to joke, all that. When I get on the field, I am a little aggressive, but it's a gladiator sport. This isn't a sport for, you know what I'm saying, soft people. So I just feel like if BYU got a problem with it, tell the quarterback not to throw picks. I'm not a dirty player at all, though, man. I just play to the whistle. And, you know, I only had, like, what, 3-4 flags in total last year? So if I'm a dirty player, then a lot of people are more dirty than me. So
they were just maybe egregious fouls as opposed to...
Yeah, I mean, they were a little out there. Absolutely. I feel like I did go a little over the top with the BYU thing. And for that, I apologize. But I played to the whistle. That wasn't a flag. You know what I'm saying? So I apologize to him, and I wish him the best in New York.
But did you take a little bit of offense that Louisiana was ranked ahead of y'all?
Oh, that's not going to last long.
Okay.
that's not going to last too long. I don't really focus on that stuff like that, but our rank is going to go up. I don't foresee us staying at whatever we are, 24, 23 for too long. So we're going to move in front of them real soon.